exchange for media. News, by all means, has been the most sought after genre in last few months. Going by the BARC numbers, COVID-19-led lockdown resulted in as much as 200% hike in viewership of channels that brought you reliable and credible news. To talk more about the genre and the growth and the leadership decisions that made different channels, news channels, stand out in this cluttered world of news, today we have someone who leads one such network, Mr. Barun Das, CEO, TV9 Network. Welcome to the show, Barun.
Thank you, Nazia.
So, Barun, as we start, I would want to understand from you how challenging have been last few months. COVID-19 has just changed the situation completely. It must have been very difficult to come to office, work. We people are still working from home. You know, just take us through the journey.
Well, this pandemic affected the entire world. And we have come up with this new normal now. But during this journey, as we went into lockdown during end of March, there was no new normal. People were grappling across the world with this new virus, which nobody had very deep information about. So for news channels, we had a completely different challenge. We are the fourth estate, and we are part of the essential services. So we couldn't shut shop and sit at home. Being the CEO, even I had attended office every single day during the lockdown, including Sundays. I couldn't come to terms with this fact that I would be sitting in my home in AC room, and then the reporters and others in the office back there, they would be exposing themselves, which is an unknown risk. But at the same time, we have communicated to the entire team that, listen, you had a choice of joining as a teacher in a school, or going and working or being a writer, being a poet. Every choice was there with you. But you chose to be part of media. So this is the time you have to live up to the occasion. So we couldn't shut shop. And then I gave the examples that what if all the doctors take leave and say that, no, we are not going to treat you. What will happen to you? So it was a very challenging situation for us, but the focus of our operation that time was that be true to your identity. You're the fourth estate. People are worried. They're sitting, they're confined at home. They need the news. Give them the news and protect yourself also. Your health is of utmost importance to us, but at the same time, you got to continue to deliver, discharge your duties. So that's how we worked on, and we made sure that we follow all the government directives and norms. We work with half manpower. Sometimes we have gone through quarantine. Suddenly somebody got diagnosed with COVID. We went through, we had to shut the office for 2 days. So all ups and downs had happened, but I think we lived up to the occasion. The entire team, our entire network, we have about 80 odd people got infected so far.
Yeah, I wanted to speak to you about that. You know, the data that I got was that you had close to 100 people from your staff got infected. Your offices were sealed. If you can, you know, speak about specific instances, you know, how was it when it actually happened? How was it still continuing and delivering news even when your office was sealed?
You see, the reporters were out on the field. They are at maximum risk. They're being exposed. They're going to hospitals and all. So they are well protected, well guarded. In the office, we had cut down the manpower to half. So we started working with two shifts. And we made half the people work on a particular shift, but we extended the shift. So every day when they came to office, it's 1.5 shift. And they went back and took a day off. And the next set of people came in and worked for 1.5 shift. So that's how overall we tried to do. We have set up a parallel office. So when the office was sealed, that was a big challenge for us. We have this sprawling studio. We had a fantastic setup, but we were deprived of that for about 48 hours. So we operated from an auxiliary studio, place next to us. And it is still continuing. I mean, suddenly it's not even a day going past where we don't have a new diagnosis diagnosed with COVID. But we tried to believe with this fact that we got to live with this virus. The better side of the virus is that it's in 90% of the cases, it is asymptomatic, which I personally have spoken to at least 30, 40 people. It is fatal for comorbid and elderly people. So when you go back home, either you seclude yourself or you seclude them if there are comorbid and elderly parents at home. And take all precautions, social distancing, mask. So it's continuing. I don't think we will come out of this very quickly.
But everyone recovered.
Sorry? Everyone recovered, yeah. Everyone recovered, including one cancer survivor and one person who has severe diabetic. But they should have been more careful with their health. They should have informed us. But nonetheless, they've all survived.
Tell us about, the entire genre has seen a growth. You know, as I mentioned in my intro, there have been a 200% hike. But these are also times, you know, when credibility plays a very significant role. You know, you have to give credible news. You have to give, people have to believe in you. People have to trust you. So what kind of content decisions did you take? And or what would you think worked for you that, you know, you saw such a significant increase in your viewership during these 3-4 months?
You see, the business of news operations, there are 3 factors which give rise to growth of viewership. I think these 3 factors are exhaustive also. 1, obviously content. 2 is promotion. And 3 is distribution. And when we do all 3 of them together in tandem, then there's something called a multiplier effect, which sets in. One of the first basic marketing principles which we were taught in our business school. So that is what we applied. We were a little lucky in the sense that we were planning to relaunch the channel during the month of January, but with the logo change, etc., ministry took a little longer. So finally, the relaunch happened in the first half of March. So relaunch is all pervasive, new look, new FPC, new promotions. And we planned innovative kind of promotions across the country. Later on, we had to withdraw most of them outdoor, etc. But local TV channels and digital, we've actually flooded that. And then comes content. One part of content is look and feel. If you have seen our channel just before this relaunch, and if you see the channel, you'll see there's a marked difference. And I would possibly, it's a creator's bias maybe, but I think our channel is one of the best looking channels amongst the Hindi news channels in the country now. That's my feel. And in content, you know, we were a fringe player just before the lockdown. Fringe player because we launched only about a year back. People didn't know about it. There was no promotion happened. We were our content was good, but our look and feel needed a little bit of improvement. But a lot of people didn't know about us. So during lockdown, 2 things had happened. 1, we had improved the channel's look and feel and content. I'll come to content soon. 2, there's a heavy promotions in local regional news channels as well as digital. And 3, people were sampling more news channels anyway. You know, in case of this uncertainty, you were saying the 200% growth in news viewership. So sampling had increased. So once you sample something new, you like it, you stick with it. It's a very simple way of looking at it. And now in terms of content, what we did, in 1 word, I would like to say that despite being a very new nascent channel, just about 1 year old, we have set the agenda many times. And not that we have compromised with our credibility ever, because that's the first attribute to a news channel. I mean, people will reject you the moment your credibility is questionable. And we've given a variety of content. If you just look at our prime time, it starts at 4 o'clock and there are branded programs. Each one is coming after another, heavy promotions on the channel, across, outside the channel. And in terms of content, the focus was COVID. And then we have identified, we're the first to identify there's a common enemy to the world. And of course for India, which now had turned out to be the biggest enemy for us, which is China. If you go back and see Blogger, that you will see that our focus on exposing China had started way back in early April. And then now that has become a very in thing in the genre. And then we also had been very focused on COVID-related information in a very formatted, structured way. If you see the channel, you'll see there are several fast programs, fast news programs, and giving the detail in a crisp way. That worked. And then 3rd is the global. You would be surprised to see that the even Hindi news audience has become so very hungry for global news, global update. we had been doing reporting from 10 different countries at that point in time. And we have focused a largely on the US, China, and then what's happening in Korea. So there was a global perspective in our coverage, which people loved. And it, you know, with the ratings coming after 7 days, we all know what's working, what's not working. So it gives you a fairly good idea that where you need to focus on. So that's how it moved along for the last 13, 14 weeks.
Arun, coming to, I mean, you're the CEO of the company. You are supposed to drive the business and the growth. There is this belief that, you know, news, despite all the numbers, is still undervalued. You know, it doesn't get that kind of rates which, you know, a GEC or maybe other channels get. Would you agree with me, and would you want to speak about it?
Of course. I think you've hit the nail on the head. I think news is highly undervalued, and in the current situation, it is going to be even more undervalued. You see the way things had happened. Newspapers have actually been the worst sufferer. I mean, you're talking to someone who could not start a day without a newspaper, but I now that I've got over the habit, I don't think I'm going back to newspaper again. GECs did not have fresh programming, they've suffered. So people, and then uncertainty, all these things have driven traffic to the news channels, and the news channels viewership growth has been stupendous. And yes, coming back to this undervaluing thing, it is. I mean, for instance, if you take a regional channel, let's say in Maharashtra, a regional channel, audiovisual channel, that actually can command only a fraction of the rates that even a city radio station can command. Now, that is height of undervaluation. Here, you're talking about audio-only medium. Yes, it's non-intrusive, but here you're talking about an audio-visual and entire Maharashtra. And then, even if you see the cost structure of a television channel and a radio station, it's vastly varying. So news overall is undervalued. This is the time, I don't think that we would take the opportunity, leverage the opportunity and try and increase the rate. But I think advertisers and clients will have to start seeing the value, and they will have to start believing that news pays. And if the industry, the entire industry can come together and work towards working with each other, I think we would be able to exhibit that news pays. And I think the undervaluation of news industry in India in terms of advertising rate should see some correction.
Arun, one of the reasons a lot of experts attribute this under, you know, the segment being undervalued is that there's too much fragmentation in the segment. But then we all contribute to it. You know, we have so many channels. Would you want to speak on that? I mean, do you agree that, you know, it is the fragmentation which is also resulting in the prices not taking that kind of a...
There's a thumb rule which you can apply to Indian media sector. The thumb rule is that there is fragmentation everywhere. The top three in any genre will comfortably be viable in terms of business. The fourth and the fifth, if their business operations are robust, if they've managed their cost well, they would still be able to make business sense out of the venture. Now the rest, even advertisers don't look at. I mean, if you talk about Telugu market, if there are 20 Telugu news channels, I don't think the advertisers look beyond even the number two or three. Similarly, nationally, I think because there are varying advertisers and the affordability varies, you still have advertising viability in channels which are even number 7, number 8, number 9. So that creates a little bit of pressure on the advertising rate because if you have a cheaper option, you might go there. But the cheaper options, when we were 4% and now we are 10% market share, I mean, we understand the difference that the advertisers look at a 10% market share channel and a 4% market share channel. So fragmentation, according to me, have a very little effect on it. Primarily, the leaders should drive the rate. Somebody has to take some bold step to say that, no, I am going to change it, even if there's a temporary loss in revenue. And then again, I'm saying that it has to be collaborative. At this point in time, the world needs to stand together. And everybody has to work towards solution-driven approach.
Arun, in the last few months, your network has really done well. You know, it has become one of the leading networks. Your channel TV9 Bharat Varsh is doing pretty well. What kind of leadership, bold leadership decisions do you think you or your editor took that worked for you? Because you just spoke about, you know, taking some bold steps. So what were those bold steps that you took that worked for you?
No, I didn't. I didn't say that we've taken bold steps.
Okay, but you said that, you know, you have to take bold steps sometimes to grow.
No, I am saying that we've taken fundamental steps.
Okay.
There was no bold step. Bold step is, I mean, I'm coming to that when we talk about the future plan. Fundamental works. And another thing I always believe, to be ordinary is extraordinary. We didn't want to do anything extraordinary. We already had two leading channels who are undisputed leaders for over a decade, which is Telugu and Kannada. We had gained leadership in Marathi and Gujarati over the last 6 months or so. And Bharatvarsh, I just explained that it is a combination of distribution. There's a significant improvement in distribution front we've done. When we changed position on Fridish, if you go back and see that, immediately the rural viewership went up. I mean, this is like as elementary as anything. We focused on marketing and promotions. A lot of things that we've done, we've started doing, that's being followed by the industry now. And content, I've told you that it's a relook, a relaunch, a very beautiful look and feel. And focus on content which people would love to see, people would like to know. The changing taste of viewership, as I said, that the global news has become a very, very in thing, even with the news viewers. So these all have become. And then finally, you know, the company or the CEO is as good as a team. The team has been extraordinary. They have lived up to the occasion. We have recruited some key people in the senior managerial positions, top managerial positions across the country. So everybody worked in tandem. It's only the synchronization of each one of us, our output, and that's resulted in this growth.
Would you also speak about your expansion plans?
Well, huh? Expansion, we were looking at a couple of more regional markets just before COVID, namely Bengali and Tamil, because with that, you would have the regional network complete. The only thing, you know, the way you divide India, there are six large language differentiated markets, which is Bengali, Marathi in the north, and Telugu, Tamil, Kannada, and Malayalam. We don't see Malayalam to be a bigger market, but if you've gone to Tamil and Bengali, we would have covered the large language differentiated market. But obviously after COVID, we had to go back to the drawing table. But the expansion really, which will unfold soon, which is what you carried this morning, that Raktim has joined as Studio 9's COO, would be on the digital domain. So the group did only have a very just a presence in the digital side of content, but that's future. Everything will make a transition from traditional TV to the digital delivery system. That is going to happen sooner than later. So that's our focus. We're expanding the digital team. We are recruiting across the country. And we had a English news channel, which is Bangalore-based, News 9, which we shut down. As you know, we are converting that into a national offering now, but it'll be only on web. So we are not going for trend. Only on the web. It's a web TV. So that
by when is it likely to make a comeback?
I think we're targeting a launch date of October 1 for this News9Live.com, which is a web TV.
We've now been joined by Mr. Batra, who's director and editor of Business World as well as and founder of Exchange for Media.
Barun's friend, I've known Barun for a long time. Barun, congratulations on
thank you, Anurag,
helping TV9 grow and taking it to a new journey. You know, tell us, a lot of people are very anxious, jealous, skeptical about this ratings that you're getting. You know, how is TV9 getting these ratings, you know, and all kinds of WhatsApps are floating around. So what do you have to say to people who are, you know, who are in not being able to accept what TV9 has achieved?
You were not there, I just explained to Nazia that we only stuck to fundamentals. And because this industry is quite transparent, you know, you have a logger where you see the content. And you have a viewership numbers after 10 days that appears on your laptop. One will have to just go back and do the exercise, then they'll get to know. For instance, I've just said that, I mean, our focus on China, our focus on global news, that's been followed by the industry now. If you look at the prime time, you'll see that prime time is largely focused, even before this Galwan Valley had happened, even before that. On the COVID, the China has become, with COVID, China has become a common enemy, right, of the world. So we turned the focus in April, the rest of the industry turned the focus much later. So I think if somebody goes back and does the homework, everything is very apparent, everything is very on the face. But I learned that, I don't know about this skepticism or jealousy or whatever, I don't want to comment about it, but I did learn that TV9 Bharatvarsh was not in the consideration list in terms of review for most of the leading channels. Now, that something is complacence at its best. I mean, and then finally, some people have taken us in the consideration list and started reviewing us only when we have overtaken them. So the jealousy it's a competitive market. I would also feel bad if somebody from below comes ahead of me and I'm a 15-year-old brand or a 20-year-old brand. I would have felt bad, so. But I think it's a part of the game. And if one sticks to basic, I think everybody would be able to deliver the kind of growth that we've seen. Or everybody will be able to understand the kind of growth that we've enjoyed.
Thank you. Varun, I want to ask you one poll question. Nazia is the editor of Exchange for Media.com. I joined it because I've known you from the day I started Exchange for Media. And, you know, the day you entered news broadcast media, whether it was ABP News under Uday Shankar's leadership or when you became the CEO of Zee News and grew it. Now, tell us, you've also brought in very good talent on the business side and the editorial side in TV9. Tell us about how has that contributed and what kind of talent have you brought in?
See, this business is all about people. Technology is the other aspect, is just an enabler. And people, which are one on the content side, one on the business side, and the support staff. On the content and the business side, you really need good people, and the business is as good as the people are. In fact, the leader or the CEO is also as good as the team is. So we had to see this brand TV9. You know that they were undisputed leaders in Telugu and Kannada. Brilliant brands, but they got built on their own, mostly. I mean, when I went back and searched for it, I didn't see this really concerted effort to build those brands. Sometimes, being an early mover, you go to a place which is unsurmountable. I mean, people can't reach there. But then, with strong editorial product, you need to build the corporate entity. That is what I've tried to do. Bharatvarsh was a new brand. It was struggling at 4%, 4.5%. But then, again, it is not only about content. When you're a new brand, you have to go for promotion, you have to go for sampling, distribution, so everything put together. So I got in people who, according to me, are the best in the industry in all aspects. In the content, if you see that even both Kannada and Marathi editors are new. We've got a new group editor, as in B.B. Rao, you know. There's a brilliant team which was existing in TV9 Bharatvarsh, which was waiting to explode, which is under the leadership of Hemant Sharmaji, who's a news director, and Sant, the editor of TV9 Bharatvarsh. I call him a magician. I mean, he's got the pulse. He knows how to communicate. So people who are within the system, Telugu, complete old team has been retained, and a group of people who have come from outside. Now it's a homogeneous, well-gelling team, which is moving as a unit. So when you move as a unit, you have a higher momentum.
Thank you, Varun. Back to you, Nazia.
Thanks, Anurag sir, for joining us. Varun, I wanted to come back to the issue of China that, you know, you were speaking earlier, that your content on China really made that difference making your channel stand out and in the viewership numbers. Would you want to speak more on it? And, you know, what kind of content were you giving out, which was different from, you know, what other channels were giving? And what sort of leads did you have on that?
Okay, I will go deep into the content. Instead of my going deep into the content, I would like to invite the news director, Hemant Sharmaji. So he's a veteran. I don't need to introduce him. So, कंटेंट के बारे में
खाना
के
बारे में
ये बड़ी बात
जी बताएं
नहीं वरुण जी बोल रहे थे कि आप एक बहुत बड़ा रीजन ये था भारतवर्ष को सारे बाकी चैनल से अलग करने का कि आप लोग बहुत ज्यादा चाइना के बारे में बहुत पहले
नॉट ओनली चाइना नॉट ओनली चाइना इट्स अ ग्लोबल पर्सपेक्टिव
पूरा जो ग्लोबल पर्सपेक्टिव है कोविड पर भी
जो देश के खिलाफ जो विदेशों में साजिश चल रही थी धारा 370 हटने के बाद ये पिछले साल अगस्त से मैं बता रहा हूँ आपको उसके बाद हमने लीड किया पाकिस्तान में क्या हो रहा था पाकिस्तान 370 को लेकर हमारे देश में क्या गड़बड़ी करना चाहता था बलूचिस्तान में किस तरह की दिक्कतें हो रही थी पीओके में वो कितना शोषण कर रहा था अत्याचार कर रहा था पाक अधिकृत कश्मीर में से हमारे हमारे देश में कौन सी आतंकवादी गतिविधियां हो रही थी पाकिस्तान में कौन से मंदिर तोड़े जा रहे थे और हिंदुओं पर कैसा अत्याचार था हम अकेले चैनल थे जिसने अपना रिपोर्टर पाकिस्तान भेजा हम अकेले चैनल थे कुछ एक आध और लोगों ने भेजा लेकिन वो लाहौर के आगे नहीं जा पाए लेकिन हमारा हमारा जो रिपोर्टर था उसने पाकिस्तान में हिंदुओं के का अत्याचार और मंदिर तोड़े जाने की पूरी विस्तृत रिपोर्ट हमें फाइल की तो इसका हमको फायदा मिला जब चीन ने गड़बड़ शुरू की इस देश के खिलाफ षड्यंत्र किया दो 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 स्तरों पर एक तो सीमा पर कर रहा था दूसरा कोरोना के पीछे भी था बाद में दुनिया ने भी जाना तो हमने सबसे पहले कोरोना को पहचाना हमने 8 जनवरी को एक बड़ा प्रोग्राम किया कोरोना पे और बताया देश की जनता को जिस समय कोरोना दुनिया में तो थोड़ा थोड़ा जाना जा रहा था इस देश में नहीं जाना जा रहा था उस समय में हमने बताया कि ये कोरोना वायरस चीन में फैला है चमगादड़ों से फैला है जिसको 12 दिन बाद 20 जनवरी को चीन ने मंजूर किया तो हम इस देश के खिलाफ चीन में जितने भी षड्यंत्र हो रहे थे उस पर उंगली रखने वाले पहले लोग थे आप हम अभी वरुण जी ने बताया होगा कि वरुण जी की ही का ही आइडिया था वो इन्हीं का ब्रेन चाइल्ड था हमने प्राइम टाइम में फिक्र आपकी और परवा देश की दो प्रोग्राम शुरू किए फिक्र आपकी तो इस देश की जनता की फिक्र करने वाला केंद्रीय कार्यक्रम है जो फ्लैगशिप प्रोग्राम 9 बजे का लेकिन जो परवा देश की है वो मैं हम लोग पिछले 100 दिन से सिर्फ चाइना पर कर रहे हैं सबसे पहले हमने पहचाना कि ये चीन गड़बड़ कर रहा है और उसका हमें फायदा मिला 100 दिन से कर रहे हैं उसमें चाहे कोविड हो चाहे अभी गलवान घाटी तो अभी हुआ है गलवान घाटी से पहले देश की जो समस्याएं थी चाइना किस तरह से गड़बड़ कर रहा था कौन से षड्यंत्र थे हमने सब पहली बार एक्सपोज किया
जब से आर्टिकल 370 हटा है उसके बाद से ये शुरू हुआ है तो मतलब इट इज बिकॉज के हमारी कंट्री में थोड़ा इंटरनल डिस्टर्बेंस हो गया है जिसकी वजह से जो नेबरिंग कंट्रीज है वो हमारा एडवांटेज लेना चाह रहे हैं
नजर जी ये तो एक सवाल है ही है हम कोई ऐसा नहीं है कि हम केवल विदेशी मामलों पर ही उंगली रखते हैं जब कोरोना आया और कोरोना बहुत बुरी तरह फैलने लगा इस देश में और कोरोना को लेकर जब सरकारें राजनीति करने लगी तो TV9 भारतवर्ष ही पहला चैनल था जिसने बताया कि बंगाल में गड़बड़ हो रही है बंगाल में मौतें छिपाई जा रही हैं बंगाल में डेड बॉडी का डिस्पोजल नहीं हो रहा है हम वहां पर भी पहले आदमी थे और शायद वरुण जी बताएंगे आपको कि इस वजह से कोलकाता में हमारी व्यूअरशिप हमारा मार्केट शेयर नंबर 1 है
हाँ, हम तो नेशनली 4-5 है बट बंगाल एंड कोलकाता में वी आर नंबर 1
And, actually, I wanted to speak to you about regional markets. You know, you're one of the leaders in regional markets. And regional, they say, even when we come back to print, you know, I want to go back to our business.
नहीं अब 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 हम अब हम national market की भी दौड़ में हैं ऐसा ना कहिए कि हम regional
national में तो आप हैं national के बारे में तो हम बहुत देर से भी discussion कर ही रहे थे. So, but you know, a lot of players say that you know the future of journalism is in regional domain. Because even apps are becoming regional. Regional newspapers are, you know, selling, are doing much better than, you know, the national newspapers. So, would you want to speak about this whole concept of, you know, going regional?
Regional, it's not today. You know, if you see, I don't recall the the reports clearly now. When I was here in media industry earlier, during 2007 and 13 with Zee, that time also, if you see, even the growth of television was largely contributed by the growth in regional markets. And regional markets, as I said, that you can break the country in 3 regions. One is Hindi speaking. One is small language differentiated markets, which is an Odia, which is a Bhojpuri, which may be a Gujarat. And there are six large language differentiated markets. So these have very, very large consumption of content in their native language. So that has been propelling the growth, not only in news, also in GEC. And going forward, it's not journalism, it's going to be in regional. With digitization, the news consumption also is becoming very, very localized, hyper-local. So that can, when you go hyper-local, it's a regional language. Even in India, if you take Hindi and the six top languages, which I said, they contribute to about 90% of the total population. We speak the seven languages. So it'll move to regional. What is in the TV news context, what I see as regional is that, you see, you would agree that Hindi news television has really, really suffered a lot over the last 2-3 years because the early adopters were digital consumers who were mostly English consumers. So they shifted from there. For the next 10 years, Hindi and regional television in news will continue to grow. Maybe they'll follow the path which the print has followed over the last 10 years, but it will slow down.
अंग्रेजी के बारे में कहा, गलती से हिंदी कहा।
अच्छा, वो अंग्रेजी, sorry, अंग्रेजी, English news, English, yeah. So it'll continue to grow in the regional markets because India's population is there and there's a consumption of content in mother tongue. The propensity would remain in India.
और दूसरी बात है ना, जैसे मैं वरुण जी को compliment करूँगा इस मामले में कि जब regional forces strong होती हैं, आप देखिए ना, हमारी जो पॉलिटी है वो उसका उसके जो नेशनल फोर्सेस थी वो टूटने लगी पिछले, मतलब 80 के दशक के बाद से रीजनल ताकतें पैदा हुई। तेलुगु में तेलुगु प्राइड पैदा हुआ, कन्नड़ में कन्नड़ प्राइड पैदा हुआ, बंगाल में बंगाल प्राइड पैदा हुआ, यूपी में सपा बसपा आई। तो मुझे लगता है कि जब रीजनल ताकतें पैदा होती हैं, पॉलिटिक्स का विकेंद्रीकरण, राजनीति का विकेंद्रीकरण रीजनल स्थिति में होता है तो रीजनल बाजार भी बढ़ता है, और बाजार बढ़ता है तो अर्जुन जी की भूमिका बढ़ जाती है।
So how much is regional actually contributing to the growth right now?
For us?
Yeah.
No, we, as we said,
you know, for you, it is of course quite significant. But in general, if I talk of the industry, how much would you attribute growth of any channel right now, any network, to the regional segment?
No, see, still Hindi is a large market, followed by those four, Telugu, Kannada, Tamil, Bengali and Marathi. For us, TV9 Bharatbarsh is a news channel. I mean, if you talk about our growth now, obviously the growth would be growth, absolute growth would be largely contributed by a new channel because we are growing on a smaller base. As of now, till last year, 95% of our revenue, if not 99% of our revenue, were all from regional markets. This year, it'll come down to maybe about 70%. But going forward, if you see our kind of network in the current status, there are four regional channels and one Hindi channel. Largely, it'll be 1:1 in a steady state. So the revenue that you garner of this four regional channels, it'll be equivalent to one Hindi channel. So that is possibly the ratio. I mean, a leading Bengali channel, the kind of revenue it does, like-to-like comparison in the Hindi genre, when it is Hindi, it'll be 4 to 5 times. So three or four regional markets put together would be equal to, four or five would be equal to the national market, which is Hindi.
You also said you are likely to expand to some more markets. Is COVID, what has happened in last few months, is it actually a good time to expand? Because I don't really get too many appointment news from any network these days, except from yours. So, you are still hiring people, you are still expanding, which is actually good for our economy because not many organizations are expanding right now. But what is the strategy? What is your plan?
So, you see, first, when you go through such kind of pandemic or economic recession, which I've seen twice in my life in my professional career, 9/11 time when I was general manager in India Today Group, I've seen that. I've also seen a recession of 2008-09 when I was with Zee News. Business Today, the India Today Group wasn't a listed company, but Zee was a listed company. So if you go back and see that what happened during 8 and 9, 2008-2009, the Z News Limited, which was a listed company, continued to grow, both in revenue and in profitability. Even that time, we were recruiting people, we were launching channel while the industry was retrenching. So fundamentally, when in a recession, if you can afford it, your any expansion, it's a buyer's market, your any expansion comes cheaper if you can sustain that loss with your bottom line or with your investment. And you become judicious. You don't become absolutely, you don't cut down on your expenses completely. You got to differentiate between what is expense and what is investments. Investments will come at cheaper rate during this session. So if you can afford your bottom line, your investment can afford, you should move judiciously towards expansion during recession. That is the fundamental thing which I've always applied. And now, as I said, that the digital is what the country is saying. The revenue, digital revenue is tip of the iceberg, according to me. It will grow. And eventually all these linear TV channels will shift to digital. As we said that we shut down the English one and we are going into the digital mode. That will happen over the next 4 or 5 years. And we are late. We're late by about 15 years. Where we are starting, the others, some of the competitions have started 15 years back. So we had plans for traditional TV launches in two regions, as we said. So we held back that plan, given the recession. But on the digital front, we see it's far more prudent. It's far more advantageous to us to continue with the expansion now and sort of leverage this high news appetite, which will continue to be there in the country for at least for next 1 year.
But isme jokhim bhi bahut hai. Jab duniya expansion ko rok rahi hai, taal rahi hai, to hum expansion mein ja rahe hain.
जुडिशियस कॉल दैट यू टेक एंड देन यू हैव टू शोकेस व्हेन यू रीच योर इन्वेस्टर्स और प्रमोटर्स बाय द वे वी वर्क विद अ सेट ऑफ प्रमोटर्स आई मीन आई हैव नेवर गॉट दैट ब्रीफ आई हैव वर्क्ड इन दिस इंडस्ट्री फॉर क्लोज टू 30 इयर्स द फर्स्ट थिंग आई वाज टोल्ड व्हेन आई पिक्ड अप दिस नेटवर्क ही सेड दैट वरुण respect is the first thing that we want to do. Returns and revenue can follow. And I have not heard as a CEO that any promoter is talking in that language. And I lived up to this. On my part, I've said that not to worry. Respect and the credential is the first aspect of a news network. Revenue and returns will follow if you do your business well. So expansion is, we have to showcase that we can sustain. We have to showcase that we can actually fund ourselves or justify the additional funding which is coming in. So everybody would count every money very judiciously, very carefully now. So despite that, we've decided to go forward with this digital expansion.
Varun, I really wish you all the best. We are live and we have some questions, but we're also out of time because we had scheduled it for half an hour. We were already 40 minutes into the discussion. So I'll take one question. And if you allow me, and then maybe we can close it.
Yes, sure.
So this question has come from an anonymous attendee. Person is not given the name. What is the plan for sustainers post-COVID when people start their regular work and travel? What innovation is required for the news industry? Generally in marketing, everything is based on a habit which leads individual to take up something on a regular basis. Varun, you want to answer that?
I didn't get the question. The gentleman has made a statement.
Basically, they're asking what would be a good sustainable plan post-COVID.
See, everything has to change from now on. As I said, my first approach, which I have started writing to industry and all, first approach is everybody has to come together, at least for the foreseeable future. We have to have partnership. We have to have leverage. We have to leverage each other's strength. We have to forget the competitive nature of ours for the time being. The more we collaborate, the better we are. And the other thing which happens in all kinds of economic recession, which is again a thumb rule, you got to look at solution-driven approach. Instead of addressing problems and applying the same method that you applied to address problems, you got to look at solution-driven approach. And this new normal, which they are saying that there are many corrections COVID has brought into us. I mean, your personal health is of extreme importance. We had to wait for COVID to come and tell us that look after yourself. So those are irrespective of whether you are running a news channel or you're running a GEC channel or you're running a FMCG product. We have to imbibe many corrections within ourselves post-COVID. collectively as individuals, as corporate houses, as an economy, as a society, everywhere.
Thank you so much, Barun. Thank you so much, Mr. Malik, for speaking to us. And on that positive note, that we should right now look for solutions and not just talk about problems. And wishing Barun and the entire team of Network 9, TV9, all the best. I would like to conclude this webinar for today. Maybe we'll catch up again some other day.
One final thing, Nazia. Thank you very much for this from our side. And I must tell you that you've hit the nails on the head mostly. You've asked all relevant questions. I hope that our answers could live up to your expectations.
Absolutely.
And if there's anything left, please feel free to talk to us. And any question comes to you further down the line, we would be happy to take those
और
questions.
And we'll meet again when the leadership of the Hindi market will be in the Bharat Varsh. We'll meet again.
And I really, sincerely, from bottom of my heart, I wish you all the best. And I hope we do another program when you complete your 1 year and your market share is even more and you are in the top 2, top 3. I mean, that's the best.
No, isme koi duvidha aur koi confusion nahi hai, Najee ji.
Duvidha nahi hai, to duba lenge.
Hum to leader ke taur par paida hi hue hain Hindi market mein. Hum leader pehle rahe hain Telugu mein, hum leader pehle rahe hain Kannada mein, hum leader pehle rahe hain Marathi mein, hum leader rahe hain Gujarati mein. हम धीरे धीरे लीडर बन रहे हैं यहाँ. इसमें कोई बहुत कोई दुविधा और शक की
जरूर नहीं, मुझे कोई दुविधा नहीं है. मैं बेस्ट विशेस आपको दे रही हूँ.
थैंक यू. ऑल द बेस्ट फॉर योर फैमिली एंड योरसेल्फ एंड एवरीबॉडी हु इज वाचिंग इट. प्लीज टेक केयर ऑफ योरसेल्फ, लुक आफ्टर योरसेल्फ, लुक आफ्टर योर फैमिली.
थैंक यू वेरी मच. थैंक यू. थैंक्स फॉर टेकिंग आवर टाइम फॉर अस. थैंक्स.
नमस्कार.